have made up in your mind that enough is enough, then that's just what it is. Enough is enough. So the question I want to pose to you today is, why do church folk run out on God? Instead of running to God, why do they run away? God is the one who has protected you and given you everything in your life. I hear the old folks saying that he brought me from a mighty long way. But I don't know about anybody else in here today. He didn't just bring me from a mighty long ways, but Tim, he brought me all the way. Through sunshine and rain, through ups and downs, through trials and tribulations. Are y'all gonna pray with me this morning? Because I got some stuff I gotta get out of water. I'm not taking in 2016. I'm gonna take back everything that the devil stole from me. And let me tell you something about that bald-headed devil. He don't like me and I don't like him. Good God Almighty, he's always trying to get in my business. He's always trying to wreak havoc in my life. And let me tell you something, I want to give you my personal testimony. I've been running for a long time away from God. I started running for what folk were saying about me in church. Well, I don't feel like running no more, because the Bible says that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And I'm so glad that I serve a God who's able to clean you up and set you on straight street. Well, I gotta close. Before I go to my seat, I wanna say a little bit about Jonah. If you see what the Bible says in the book of Jonah, it says, now the word of the Lord came unto the son of Amittai, saying, arise and go to Nineveh. When God tells you to do something, you better do what God says. Don't listen to folk, friends, or your family, but you better listen to what God says. Good God Almighty, I want to stop by today to tell you that God has sent an angel in this house to give us instruction. And for so long we've been rebellious and we've been not heeding to the word of God when Pastor Gant sounds the alarm. But you better be careful how you handle what God has given unto you. An angel in this house. In 2016, I'm scared to miss church, because God may give him a word that might be my healing. God might give him a word that might be my deliverance. And if I'm at home in the bed sleeping, I miss my blessing from the Lord. Good God Almighty, look now at Jonah. Y'all, I'm trying to preach this, but Jonah rose up to flee unto Tarshish. And a lot of us, God has told us what to do in our lives, such as tithing and doing his will. And for too long, we've been wondering what the problem is. Well, the problem is you're doing it half the way, and you're not doing it all the way. God wants some folk who are going to stand up for right and for righteousness and say, for God I live, and for God I die. Well, I gotta preach on a little further. Look now at Jonah. I see him fleeing and going in another direction. Sometimes on this Christian journey, if we're not careful, you'll find yourself going in the wrong direction. If you ain't heed to somebody else's advice and don't take a word from the man of God, you'll find yourself going in the wrong direction. Look now at Jonah. I see him on that ship. Bible says that a great wind came upon the sea, and there was a mighty tempest in the sea, so that the ship was like to be broken. The Bible says that the mariners were afraid and cried every man unto his God. Come on, y'all, let's cast forth the wares that were in the ship, and we're gonna throw them into the sea. Well, I want to tell you something. Whenever there's a problem in your life, ain't nobody else gotta tell you. You know better than anybody else. You know when your heart ain't right. You know when you got an attitude with somebody else. You know when you haven't forgiven your fellow man, and you sit up in church looking all pious and sanctimonious, but you ain't going to heaven anyhow. Good God Almighty, but look now at Jonah, and I see him saying unto them, cast me into the water. Good God Almighty, if you are a problem in the church, if it's you that keep on hindering us from moving, you ought to ask God like David did, create in me a clean heart so I can serve you worthily. Well, I got to rush on to a close, but sometimes church folk, they will run out. Good God Almighty, I've learned, Tim, that some church folk are some of the messiest folk in the world. If they find something on you, they'll put their foot on your neck and try to hold you down. But anytime you find somebody that need a helping hand, the only way you ought to look down is to be lending them a hand to pull them up. The Bible says that we ought to care for one another. Good God Almighty, I read the book of Galatians where it says in Galatians that if any man be overtaken in a fault, let those who are spiritual restore one such a one in the spirit of meekness. You see, I believe the why he said it, Pastor, is because if you're not spiritual, you'll have a hard time forgiving folk in the church. If you're not spiritual, you'll have a hard time forgiving folk that done lied on you. If you're not spiritual, you'll have a hard time forgiving folk that has betrayed you. But you got to turn it over to the Lord today, good God Almighty, and put your hand in God's hand. Won't God make a way out of no way? Won't God fix any situation? He's a God you can't hurry. He'll be there. Don't you worry. Good God Almighty, he steps in right when I need him most. I'm trying to wind it up, y'all, but I feel something down on the inside. I feel a wheel that starts turning. I feel fire and it's burning, because we've got a responsibility to the Lord. No more 2015, but I'm stepping in to a brand new year. And with the new year come new possibilities. With the new year comes a brand new chance. And I want to tell you, God, today, I thank you for sparing my life. I thank you for not letting me die in the street. I thank you for picking up a little boy by the name of Walter Byrd and bringing him back to the fold. Anybody in here happy? I ain't by myself. You messed up sometimes and you stepped out on God, but he gave you another chance. Ain't he all right? Ain't God all right? I say he's all right. He'll make a way out of no way. If you just trust and believe. I got any believers in here today? I'm a believer. I believe in God. I believe in the Godhead. I believe in God's word. I believe in the Bible, that it was written by divinely inspired men, that it has truth without any mixture of error for it matter, that God is my God, that God is the only God, that God, there's no other God above him. Don't run out on God, but instead, you are to run to God. Trust and believe. The Bible says, trust in the Lord with all of thine heart and lean not to thine own understanding. But in all of your ways, you ought to acknowledge him. And see, when you trust in him, you're telling him, I'm putting it all on you. I'm giving it all to you. And when he says, lean not to thine own understanding, you got to understand some stuff. Tilting time comes in all of our lives. You're going to have to lean on something. And when you lean, you're going to have to base your strength on its strength, whether it can hold you up or not. You have to trust in God. God will make a way out of no way if you trust and believe in him. Come on, give the Lord a big hand. I've had some good days, and I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days. Hey, some sleepless nights. But when I with my bad days, I won't complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low. Vicky, I can hardly see the road. I asked the question, Lord, but he knows what's best for me. Although my weary eyes cannot see, but I'll say thank you, Lord, and I won't, yeah, complain. God has been so good to me. He been good to anybody else? He's been good to me. More than this whole world and you can ever be. He's been so good. He's been so good to me. Dry all my tears away. Turn my midnights in today. And I'll say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And I won't complain.
Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. Oh, how we thank God for this blessed word that he preached. I'd like to say one thing about Walter. Walter been a friend of mine. I've been knowing Walter since I was 8 years old. So that means I've been knowing Walter 50 years. And today I consider Walter a friend. And Walter, and God has put in my heart to reach out to Walter. In 1 Corinthians chapter 4, Paul tells us not to judge nothing before it's time. For only God himself knows the end of things. And when God raised up a seed, only him knows the end of that. When we preach the word, we preach the word with all seriousness. And I want to thank Walter, for he has been a blessing to me. I want to thank Pastor Gant for the many opportunities that he has given our brother Walter. Pray. And those of you that is in the nursing home ministry, thank God for those of you that are here. Thank God for your service. Thank you for your faithfulness. And thank Ella for your faithfulness always in leading us. Now, we come to the moment where we have heard the word. And some of us may be here today has done the same thing that Jonah has done. God has called you to do a thing. And you ran away from God instead of running to God. If someone feels right now that you have turned your back on God, will you come? Now is the opportunity to come. Come now while you yet have a chance. For we know not what tomorrow will bring, for tomorrow is not promised to us. Come now while you have the opportunity. If you want to change your circumstance and your situation, come to a Savior that can fix a broken vessel. Sometimes we might need to say, Lord, take me back down to the potter's house and put me on the wheel, Lord, and mold me according to thy purpose. He can do it. He can fix you. He can mold you right now. If you need prayer, come and we'll pray for you. As Pastor Gunn always says, it's not about a church, it's about a kingdom. If you walked away, you want to be reunited back to your church, or go to another church, we can send you there. But come while you have a chance to come. Everybody that's here, if you're saved, if you're saved and you know you're saved, will you raise your hand, please? Oh, how we thank God for a safe house. Oh, Heavenly Father, we just want to say thank you, Father God. We thank you for your word, Lord God. We thank you for what we heard this day, Father God. We thank you for your preached word, Father God. And now, Father God, we receive it and believe it with all our heart, mind, and soul, Father God. We just want to say thank you for what you're doing with our brother Walter, Father God, that you would continue, Father God, to have your hands upon him, Father God. Thank you for every angel, Father God, that you have placed in his life, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for our pastor again, Father God, that he has taught us so much, Father God, about you, Father God. We just thank you for every Bible study, Father, that we learn more about you, Lord God. And we just thank you, Father God, about the teaching of the spirit of giving, Father God, and all those that have followed and believe that if you give, you will receive, Father God. And they say that in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen and amen. Amen. Let me turn it back in the hands of Pastor Gunn.
Amen. This is the hour for the hymn. Amen. I want us to believe God beyond every possibility, beyond every ailment that we have. You may know someone who that needs to be healed, delivered, or set free. We can't run a Christian race if we are not prepared. This morning, while we come with our heads and our hearts heavy because of a loved one or someone that we know, we can pray. We can touch heaven with our prayers, and heaven will in turn touch us. The Bible said one could put 1,000, two could put 10,000. If all of us can join together and believe God, we can move any mountain that we feel that's unmovable with our faith together. I am a believer that I believe that the prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Calvary, the city of Shreveport, the local communities that surround us, every church in this city, we need healing. Our nation needs healing. People are hurting. People are affected by breast cancer, other incurable ailments that we have never heard of. But today, we can believe God. And I don't have the prayer, and I don't have the faith that is emotional. I have an affirmation faith that I believe I can decree and declare. God's word is true. Anybody believe? So when we pray, we can believe God. And we have the absolute certainty. Philippians 1:6 says, being confident of this very thing, he which had begun a good work in you is going to complete it unto the day of Jesus Christ's return. I don't care what you come in contact with, it won't stop that word.
Right.
I don't care what gets on your neck, what gets on your back, get attached to your name. I don't care where you go. Jesus didn't say, you make it bad in hell.
Yeah.
He said, I'm going with you. Because
yeah.
I'm going to bring you up out of there.
Yeah.
Because that's a work that has to be done.
Yeah.
So many of us die before our time. So many of us, you know, quit the race before our time.
All right.
I like Joy. Joy ain't a preacher, but he preached to Walter in that truck.
Yeah.
Saying, why are you always running when times get hard?
Yeah.
That's right.
When you need to be running back to God.
Yeah.
That's why we can look at God. He has a work for us. And with our physical strength, we are able to do what God wants us to do. At our church, The Living Word Church, we believe in the altar. We believe in coming around, making it personal. I ask that you will come around the altar with us this morning and let's touch heaven so heaven may touch us. Can you do that? Come on, let's walk to the altar. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Praise God.
Glory to your name, Father. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Glory to your name. Hallelujah. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you. We come around this altar to be a point of contact for those who are unable to be here during this hour. Thank you for being our God. Lord, thank you for the angel of this house. We ask that you will strengthen him where he's weakened, build him up where he's torn down. Prop him up on every leaning side. Father, we thank you for the officers of this church that works closely with the shepherd. Thank you for this visual that we are here to come to pray for the health of our city, our community, our nation, our churches. We pray, God, now for healing. Heal the bodies, God. We bind every hindering spirit that's not of you, God. We tell Satan, Satan, you're a liar. We plead the blood of Jesus right now over you. In the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, God, that no weapon formed against us is going to prosper. That every tongue that rises up in judgment will be condemned. We thank you right now, God. That rheumatoid arthritis would not be a factor in your people. Cancer, AIDS, whatever the situation may be, God. We know that you have the power. Through your blood, God. For what shall wash us? Whiter than snow, nothing but the blood. So God, right now we plead the blood over every life in this place. Every life that has crossed the threshold of the doors of this place. We plead the blood of Jesus. Touch them now, God. Those in the nursing home, touch them right now. Those in the prison, touch them right now. Those in the hospital,